rules are basic, rules are like this. So the first one is called as a product rule, which says that if there is a task, which can be broken into subparts, okay? So focus on the term like subpart, and if the first part you can, the first subpart you can do in N1 ways, and the second subpart you can do in N2 ways, then the total number of ways that entire task can be done is N1 into N2, right? So that's why it is called as product rule. So a simple example can be that, if you take a root problem that if you are at the university campus and you are asked to reach SDA via Karunamoy. Okay, so Karunamoy, maybe you have to meet some friend, and from there you will go together. So from university, there are maybe four ways to reach Karunamoy, right? And from Karunamoy, you have maybe three ways to reach sector 5. So total number of ways you can reach sector 5 is 4 into 3 or 12, right? Now, this is generalizable meaning that you can extend it to more than two subparts. So you might have more subparts, right? So there can be another subpart, right? So maybe from sector 5 you'll go to New Town, right? And that sector 5 to New Town you go in another three ways. So you can again multiply 3 into 4 into 3, right? So that's the way the product rule can be extended. Okay, all right. So a very simple example: the chairs of an auditorium are to be labeled with an upper case English letter followed by a positive integer not exceeding 100. So what is the largest number of chairs that can be labeled differently? So you want every chair to be numbered uniquely or differently. So following this numbering scheme, that you have a uppercase English letter followed by a positive integer not exceeding 100, how many number of chairs can be there? Okay, so I think you can very easily calculate. So if you represent with the nomenclature that there are empty spots, right? There are empty spots, right? So like this. So this can be filled up in 26 ways, okay? Because it is the uppercase letter, it has been told, and this can be filled by any number between 1 to 100. So it can be 2600 ways, right? 2600 ways. Okay, so that many chairs can be numbered uniquely. Okay, so similar to product rule, you have a sum rule. Now, sum rule actually doesn't talk about part, but talks about alternative way of doing the same thing. So it's like I ask you that, how many ways you can reach Karunamoy? So you say, okay, what I will do is I can go by cab, I can go by auto, I can go by rickshaw, I can go by my own car, right? I can go by own bike or something like that. So all these actually are independent ways, okay? All these are actually independent ways of doing the same thing, right? And then, so these individual ways that I gave you example, okay, so all values were like 1, right? So I'm counting, okay, it is APCAB 1. So it may not be, so you can formulate it in a different way also. So maybe there are two APCABs, right? So when I say APCAB, so if I go by APCAB, when I say I can go by N1 ways, so I can actually probably go by two ways, right? Either by Ola or by Uber maybe, okay? And then if you think of going by bus, so maybe there are certain number of buses, maybe 5 buses, which ply from here to Karunamoy, right? So here then into the value of N2 will be 5, right? So if someone asks you that how many ways you can reach either by APCAB or by, by a bus, so your answer will be 7, okay? And there is something very important over here, which says that none of the set of N1 way is the same as any of the set of N2 ways. So this is very important, which tells that actually there is no intersection. Okay, actually says that there is no intersection. Okay, so if I look at a problem now, okay, so suppose that either a member of the mathematics faculty or a student who is a mathematics major is chosen as a representative to a university committee, okay? So how many different choices are there for this representative? If there are 37 members of the mathematics faculty and 83 mathematics major. Okay, now the important part comes, which cover this intersection part, and no one is both a faculty member and a student. Okay, so if you have to find that out, then how many ways you can do that? Right, so it will be simple addition, right? Right, the formula says. Okay, so you'll just add up, 83 with 37, and you will get that. Okay, it is 120. Right, okay. So let's go to another problem. Okay, just one minute. So basically, can you still see my screen?
No, sir.
Okay. So this is something interesting happening. If I don't put it in play mode now, can you see it? I'll have to present again. Yeah. So, what it says is, this is a problem. Now, basically, what we are trying to tell you is that, okay, so these are the fundamental rules. Now, these fundamental rules you can use for solving a particular type of problem, okay, or not a particular type of problem. You can solve some general type of problem. So one of the problem we are going to look at here is that in a version of a computer language BASIC, the name of a variable is a string of one or two alphanumeric characters, okay, and here uppercase and lowercase are not distinguished. So you don't differentiate between, let's say, a variable name which is capital A5 and a variable name which is small A5, okay? Moreover, a variable must begin with a letter and must be different from the five strings of two characters that are reserved for programming use, right? So we see this all the time, right? So you cannot have a variable which is like if, right? Because it forms a part of the loop structure or decision structure, okay? So basically these are like your keywords. So how many possible different variables names are there in this version of BASIC? Okay, is the question clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now I want you to, make a try.
The first place, sir, I'll have to fill it up with a character, a letter, and it could not
okay,
be
okay.
a number.
Srijit, let me take a step back. First, can you tell me that which rule you are going to use? Are you going to use a sum rule or are you going to use a product rule?
Sir,
I think product rule.
Product.
Okay. The thing is product.
First step, product, and then some, maybe.
Yeah.
Product.
Yeah. So actually, you need to use both. So you'll have to use maybe first product and then you have to use sum. You are right. Some. Yes. Now go ahead.
So the first blank space can be filled up with 26 possible possibilities, and then the second I can fill it up with 26 plus 10 but there has to be minus 5 because 5 cannot be present. So maybe it's 26 into like 26 plus 10 whole minus 5.
No, you are missing something. See, that's where, so you are only talking about the product, right? So basically, you have this N1. N1 is the one where, it is only, you have like only one character. In that case, right, so it said, right, it's a string of one or two. So if it is only one string, still you can have 26 variables, isn't it? 26 variable names, right? And then N2 is the number of variables possible, which are actually two characters. So as you correctly said, the first position will be filled up by 26 ways, okay? And the second position can be filled up in 36 ways, okay? And then it is said that 5 are reserved. So N2 will be 26 into 36 minus 5, okay? And then what is the then total of this N1 plus N2? That will be 26 plus 26 into 36 minus 5. So, a figure like this. Okay. So, V1 comes to be 26, V2 comes to 931. The total number of possibilities is actually 957. Okay. All right. Now, let's look at another problem. So, this problem we will not go and solve completely, but we'll try to develop an abstract idea because this is a typical type of problem. So this says each user on a computer system has a password, okay, which is 6 to 8 character long, where each character is an uppercase letter or a digit, right? Each password must contain at least one digit. So, there are some restrictions generally when we see that we are giving a password. So the restriction is that it has at least one digit, right? So how many possible passwords are there? Is the question clear to you? I hope the question is clear to you.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let me hear someone else also. So Priya, is the question clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. And I hope it's clear to Poulomi, Priyanshu, Ankita, Mohua, every one of you.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, first thing first, so we can understand that there is definitely a possibility of applying some rule. Why? Because there will be a set of passwords which are going to be 6 character long. There is going to be a set of characters which are going to be 7 character long, and there are going to be a set of passwords which are going to be 8 character long. So, at the very first stage, I can write N1 plus N2 plus N3. Now, I want to draw your attention to one particular word over here, which is at least. So whenever you have something like at least, there is a different way of finding this problem. So what you are going to do is you are going to find out what is the total number of solutions? Okay. Out of them, how many are invalid? And that will give you total number of valid solutions. So let me repeat, whenever you see something like at least, you can go in a complementary approach. So you find out what is the total number of solutions possible. You find out that how many of them are invalid. And when you subtract this invalid from total number of solutions, you get total number of valid solutions. Is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
All right. So, if I approach it that way, right? So, how many possible solutions are there? Let's take this N1 case where it is 6 characters. The first position can be filled up by 36 ways, isn't it? Right?
Yes, sir.
Because it can be a uppercase letter or a digit. So it's mentioned it is uppercase, right? So it is not any case. So it can be 36, right? So total number of possible solution is going to be for N1 is going to be 36 into 36 into 36, 6 times. So it is going to be 36 to the power. What are going to be my invalid solutions? So here is what maybe you have to apply your brain little bit.
All 6 characters are alphabets, not there is no digit.
Absolutely. Very good. All 6 have to be alphabet. If that is the case, then how many such possibilities are there? The first position can be by 26 ways, right? So it is same way. This will be 26 into 26 into 26, 6 times. Okay? So, you know, it will be like this, right? Isn't it? We are not going to do the laborious calculation, but you understood the concept. Similarly, I can find N2, which will be 36 to the power. And similarly, N3 is going to be.
Sorry, I think you got muted.
Is sir there? Like, is sir audible?
No. No, no. Sir is muted actually.
Hello.
Yes,
Yeah,
sir.
I hope it is clear to you.
Sir, you got muted, sir. We didn't hear you.
So you got muted and then you left and then again you rejoined and now we can hear you again.
So, okay. So you understood this 36 to the power 6 minus 26 to the power 6 part?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah. So what I said is that, so N2 will be 36 to the power 7 minus 26 to the power 7. N3 is going to be 36 to the power 8 minus 26 to the power 8.
Yes, sir.
Right? So that way you can apply this. Okay, I think, yes. So one last thing that we'll discuss today and stop. Okay, so this is called as subtraction rule. So earlier, you know, when we discussed about the sum rule particularly, and we talked about this committee problem, right? So we put a condition that none of the faculty members are a student. But, you know, it may not be realistic because there might be some faculty who are doing higher studies, maybe they are postdocs from the same university, right? So, you know, it's the old Venn diagram, right? So if I want to find out number of possibilities, right? So then I will have to, you know, subtract this part because this is counted in both A and B, right? So that is the thing that we need to do. So as we need to do the subtraction, right, which is common, which is this is called as the intersection part, right? So that's the reason you called it as a subtraction rule. And this is also another name, which is called as inclusion-exclusion principle. Okay, what it is called? It is called as inclusion-exclusion principle. All right. Now, I think let's do one quick problem. Okay. So this is the this is the notation, right? Formal notation. And again, this is a set notation, you know. So essentially, you can extend it to more than one set, more than two set, right? You can extend it to three set. The intersection part will change accordingly, right? So one of the thumb rule is that when you are calculating an intersection quotient, okay? So if it contains even numbers, okay, then it will be negative. The sign in front of that will be negative, and if it is odd number, then it is going to be positive. Okay, so this is a rule you can follow when you are taking to 3, 4, and so on and so forth. Okay, all right. Now let's look at a particular problem. So how many bit string of length 8 either start with 1 bit or end with the 2 bits 0, 0? So this is a problem we'll do. Can you quickly try? So we are talking about bit strings of length 8, right? So, you know, if I put these 8 positions, okay, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So one of the ways that it will start with the bit 1. So I fix this. So how many ways I can fill this?
2 to the power 7.
Yes, so 2 to the power 7. Right? And similarly, how many ways if I fix this as 0, 0, okay, so 2 to the power 7 actually turns out to be 128, isn't it? If I fix this 0, 0, then how many bits are left? 6 bits. How many ways I can fill this?
64.
2 to the power 6, which is 64. Now, is my number of bit strings starting with either 1 bit or end with 0, 0, 128 plus 64? Is it that? Is it 192?
No, sir.
No, why not? Because there will be some which starts with 1 and ends with 0, 0. So in both cases, these two are counted. They are included in both 128 and 64, right? So what I will do is, I will find out how many ways I can start with 1, 1 and end with 0, 0. So if I fix 3 positions, then my 5 positions are free to move. So I can fill that in 2 to the power 5 ways. So 2 to the power 5 means it is 32, right? So naturally, my answer is going to be 128 plus 64 minus 32 or 160. Okay. So let me just stop here. Okay. I'll just stop the recording.